My name's Eric White. I'm the lead climbing ranger on Mount Shasta for the Shasta-Trinity National Forest.
My name is Melon Kohlberg. I work for the botany department here in Mount Shasta Ranger District for the Shasta-Trinity National Forest.
I'm John Game. I grew up in England, but I've lived in California and Berkeley for the last 30 years, and I'm a vocational botanist.
I'm Don Farrar. I'm at Iowa State University. I'm a botanist, and I've been working with the Forest Service in the summertime identifying rare plants.
A very small plant, very rare, and it was first found on Mount Shasta in 1941 by Dr. William Bridge Cook.
And it was in a folder that was listed as unidentified. They weren't sure what it was.
As you can see, it's a very small plant, 4 centimeters, so a little less than 2 inches. And he only found a few plants, but he was able to take a sample, and since then, it hasn't been reported on Mount Shasta.
The area from Crater Lake up to Bend and that general area is the only place that it has been known prior to this. And so this is extremely significant. It says that at least at one time, it was much more widespread. And we are going to try to determine the relationship between this plant and the Oregon plants. It's possible that this is resulted from spores that were blown down from Oregon. It's also possible that it was the other way around, that maybe these were the plants that spores from here traveled to Oregon to start that population. So it's a botanical mystery, and we're starting to unravel it.
So I've had some interest in rediscovering it, and last year, a year ago, I came up here with 2 colleagues from Berkeley, and Eric and the 2 colleagues and me went up to where we thought it was, and we sussed out the area. We didn't find it, but we felt we'd sort of found out where the area where it was found, and then we've been planning to come back. We wanted a wetter year, and last year was particularly dry. This year was a bit wetter.
You know, the last few years it's become quite a treasure hunt looking for this plant, and something that small on a mountain this big, it's like a needle in a haystack.
And I've always been very interested in ferns since I was a kid, and I've become particularly interested in these moonworts, partly through getting to know Don Farrar, but from a number of reasons I've been very interested in moonworts in California.
So we put together this big trip for the summer, and then Eric and his folks found it before we ever got out here.
I was invited by Eric to go look for Patricium, and not knowing which Patricium I was looking for at the time. And took the invitation because I always love looking for them. It's a great treasure hunt. And so off we went with 2 rangers up Diller Canyon, up to the spur, 2,000-foot vertical climb and up and over several little valleys. We spent our whole day just meandering looking for this plant, and mainly focusing on associated species and color is really what I could focus on because it's so small.
And yesterday we went up and we found a few more plants, and I'm very pleased to say that's what it is, and it's a phenomenal find.
It was quite a long walk. It seemed to be a little longer this year than last year, but I think that might be because I'm a year older. It's kind of dry up there, very rocky. There's no trail, it's steep. It's not technical climbing, but it's steep. And it's really a great place because you get views of the whole of the northwest of California from up there. You see all the Marble Mountains and the Siskiyous and the Trinity Alps and Mount Eddy, which has all kinds of rare plants on it, is right across the street, so to speak.
We're looking around at the ground, and sure enough, I see this gray-green color. I see the associated species, the phlox and the pine, and there it is. I move aside a senecio that has the gray-green color, and behind it is the Botrichium, the same color as the senecio, but it's hiding behind it up against a rock. End of the day, we're like ready to go home, tired, but we found that. And then I just looked at the slope aspect, looked downhill, there it is again, went down there, found another population. So pretty happy, pretty excited, but it's a lot of work. It's a needle in a haystack.
And this was the only species I've not seen to this date, so This has been a real treat for me. And of course, the discovery is just an outstanding event. It's quite something.